Come on, why does this live action shit have been ruined? Today's TV show review will be on a 2022 live action series, and that one is The Really Loud House. Oh my god, this show is a complete big failure of the original Loud House. This show is airing on Nickelodeon, and currently streaming on Paramount Plus. This show premiered on November 3, 2022. While most of the characters from the original cartoon returned, some of them, such as the Cassagrandes and Chandler, are missing. Some bad episodes, such as the Blemish Dimish, Lincoln can be selfish sometimes. Just like in seasons 1-3 of the original cartoon, normally sweet-natured and innocent Clyde is much more sarcastic and irritable in this series than he is in the cartoon. Likewise, Lincoln also counts, as he's a lot more selfish in this series, even wanting Clyde to fail when he takes over as the man with a plan. Too much toilet and gross out humor. Luan is forced to pee in the bushes in the chore thing, with Lisa testing her Zopmaster 3000 in the bathroom. In the same episode, Lin Sr. tries to reassure his wife he can handle the management of chores, and adds, "Trust me." Rita answers back that the last time he said that, she had to poop in the forest. In Robro, Lincoln is forced to go to the bathroom in the bushes with Lana's rooster, using the bathroom. In the same episode, Lana goes number two, claiming she hasn't clogged the toilet yet. When Lin Sr. wakes up, Lana tells him to stay out of the bathroom for 7 hours, saying she clogged the toilet so bad it looks 7 hours to fix. The Blemish Dimish has someone make a voice clip song out of Lincoln's butt pimple speech. According to Lini, it's gone viral and has been seen by 8 million people. In The Guy Who Makes You Fly, Lin Jr. tells Lola to hurry up with the dump she is taking by saying, "You will never be number one until you push out that number two." As in A Loud House Christmas, Luna and Luan are taller than Lini. This time, however, Luan is also taller than Lori. Once again, Lincoln's live-action voice actor, Wolfgang Schaefer, wears a white wig. Just like in the Christmas live-action film, there are disturbing moments. In The Chore Thing, the Custard Gang had slaughtered the previous kingpin, Pablo Ice Cream Bar, and his gang by turning them into milkshakes and drinking them. In The Blemish Dimish, Lisa gets shot in the chest with an arrow after sneezing while trying to take a shortcut to school. When she visits Lin Sr. about it, he tries to yank the arrow out, but Rita stops him just in time. Considering his limited medical knowledge, this series is full of product placements and pop culture references in every episode. The Halloween special film is terrible. In All Is Fair in Love and Sleepovers, Liam has a crush on Luna, but since it's already been well established she has a girlfriend, including in the Christmas movie, Loud House fans already know it's not gonna work out. Luan does pretty bad pranks in Spelling and Doorbelling. Lincoln allowed Clyde to get hit by the boxing glove Luan planted in the fridge, claiming he already saw it coming, only to get squirted in the face when he opened the sparkling water can immediately after, which further proved Clyde's assumption that Luan shook up the can to be correct. And even worse, this show also have its own two movies from Nickelodeon and Paramount: A Loud House Christmas from 2021, and A Really Haunted Loud House from 2023, which these movies are a big failure. I prefer the Loud House movie and the Cassagrandes movie better. And look at these two masterpieces on Nickelodeon and Nicktoons. The original Loud House and its spin-off, the Cassagrandes, they are perfect and awesome. And plus, they have great characters, perfect animation, and great creativity. I prefer the original Loud House and its spin-off, the Cassagrandes, better than this live-action shit. So, what do I rate on this show? 0 out of 10. It's an abomination. This concludes this review.